31. Welcome to section 5.4. We're going to talk about dividing polynomials in this section. And the reason we want to focus on dividing polynomials is because we're heading in to graphing rational functions. So this second column in our giant trait table. We've just left polynomials behind. We should be comfortable enough with graphing a polynomial. And we're going to start looking at rational functions. And when you talk about rational functions, we are dividing polynomials. So we want to talk about how to divide polynomials leading up to us being able to graph rational functions. All right, so with that, we're going to learn two ways to divide polynomials. There's the long division method, which you've seen long division at some point in your math careers. Maybe you've actually seen it with polynomials, or maybe you've only seen it with numbers. But I'll show you how to use long division to divide polynomials. And then I'm going to show you the hack, the synthetic division, which is awesome. It's much more efficient. I love synthetic division. It gives us a ton of information. And then once you learn synthetic division, you very rarely go back to long division. There's only one time nowadays where I'll use long division. And I'll show you that one time when we get into the next section. But for the most part, I'm using synthetic division to divide polynomials. All right, so let's talk about how we use long division to divide polynomials. All right, we'll do a couple of examples with long division, and then we're going to rework these same functions with synthetic division. All right, so it says use long division to find the quotient 3x squared plus 10x plus 40 in ratio to x minus 4. And eventually, when we tack a little f of x equals onto this, we're going to be graphing this rational function. All right, so I want to use long division. So we'll go x minus 4, it needs to get divided into 3x squared plus 10x plus 40. All right, now if it's been a little while since you've done division the long way, let me just do a little bit over here. I'll put it off here so it's out of the way. All right, can we actually see that? Oop, not quite. Let me go ahead and scooch this up just so we can get it all in view. There we go. All right, so here's my little working box. So let's say I wanted to do take 8 and divide it into 248. No, we'll go 249, just so it doesn't go evenly. I want to make sure there's a remainder. So what you would do is you would say, well, what do you need to multiply 8 by to get to 24, right? That was always, what do I multiply this divisor by to get to this 24 here? And I would say 8 needs to get multiplied by 3 in order to reach 24. And so I'm going to do the same thing here, but we're only going to be concerned with the leading term in both the numerator and the denominator. So for right now, all I care about is the 3x squared because that's the lead term in the numerator, and the x because that's the lead term in the denominator. So you ask yourself, what do you need to multiply x by to get to 3x squared? And the answer to that is I would need to multiply x by 3x. Okay, so let's go back to our numerical example. After you figure out what you need to multiply 8 by to get to 24, the next thing you do is you take 3 and multiply it by 8 and write 24. Well, I'm going to do the same thing here, but just take a look. You're multiplying 3x to a binomial. So you need to multiply the 3x to the x and the 3x to the negative 4. So 3x times x is 3x squared. 3x times negative 4 is negative 12x. And let's go back to what we did with numbers. I would take this 24 here and I would subtract it. Right, so now when I want to subtract this binomial, I need to send that negative. I need to distribute that negative to both terms. So if I want to erase those parentheses, if I distribute the negative, all right, this will become negative 3x squared, but this will become positive 12x, right? Because I'm subtracting that binomial. All right, so here, the next thing we did was we did 24 minus 24, I had a 0. Let's do the same thing over here. Now, 3x squared minus 3x squared cancels. That's by design, right? 10x plus 12x is 22x. So yeah, I had a 0 here and a 22x here, but same idea, right? What would we do next on this numerical example? We would bring the 9 down. So same deal here. I'm going to bring the plus 40 down. All right. So I usually wouldn't write 09, we'd just write 9. All right, how many times does 8 go into 9? Just the one time. So here we go again. Now I have x minus 4, and my new binomial, my new polynomial or binomial specifically is 22x plus 40. And again, I only care about the lead term. What do I need to multiply x by to get to 22x? Well, that is 22, right? Just like I had the 1 here, I go 1 times 8, I would write 8. Well, now I'm going to do 22 to the binomial x minus 4, so I'm going to get 22x. 22 times negative 4 is negative 88. Again, I would subtract the 8, so I'm going to subtract the binomial. All right, I'm going to have a remainder of 1 here. And let's see what we have. These cancel. 40 plus 88 is 128. And that is my remainder, just like 1 is my remainder here. I think back in previous math classes, you would write remainder 1. That would probably be something that you did. In here, how you are with long division of polynomials, you know you're at your remainder level when the degree on your lead term here is more than the degree on your lead term here. So what I mean by that, if you looked at our first division, we went x into x squared. This one was larger, so I kept on going. Here we went x into x. They were tied, kept on going. Here I went x into a constant. This had a higher power of x. This was x to the 1. This is technically x to the 0. So when this power here is higher than this power here, you know you can stop. So I'm at the stopping point. And here's how we would write this up. We would say that this quotient is equal to 3x plus 22 plus my remainder of 128 over x minus 4. All right, so that's how we do polynomial long division. In the same way that I could have said 249 over 8 is like saying 31 and 1/8. All right. So you do whatever your remainder is, and you put it in ratio to that divisor. All right, so there's one example of polynomial long division. So I'm gonna hit the pause button, and we're gonna come back and try example 2 together. All right, I'll see you in a few. Bye.